Now, the labor impasse at the Blaefor mine in Carletonville on the West Rand continues. The mine had to shut down for 2 weeks after several National Union of Mine Workers members were dismissed for taking part in a strike. It's reported the mine has started its own union and wants employees to be part of that. ENCA's Govan Whittles is in Blaefor Eetzicht, in the West Rand of Gauteng, there with an update. And Govan, we heard you earlier on talking to workers and their concerns. This allegation that the union started its own, the mine started its own union that it wants workers to join is disconcerting, to say the least. What is management saying about it?
Yeah, we'll hear from the general manager of the mine in a few moments, and we're at the Blaefor gold mine right now. It's been redone, Tulasizwe, in a big way. This is a mine that was essentially overrun back 2013, even before then, by Zama Zamas, and suffered a lot of losses. And the Blaefor Gold Company has come in, restarted the mine, and now they're in the news because one of their directors, Mr. Well Sempe, was murdered, and there is a standoff between the National Union of Mine Workers and the Blaefor Workers Union, which represents the workers here. And we've been told by the NUM that they're the only union, that the company is forcing the workers to join the union. But let's get the other side of the story now with the general manager of the mine, Mr. Louis Lamsley. Thank you so much for your time, Mr. Lamsley. Let's begin with the issue of the murder of one of your directors, Mr. Well Sempe. What happened to him, and what were the circumstances under which he was murdered?
Mr. Sempe was traveling to work on the 2nd of March at about 6:30 in the morning from his home in Fochville. He stopped at a four-way stop, and the reports are that a hitman walked up to his car and shot him three times. This person then walked away, got into his vehicle and left. So it was not a hijacking. Nothing was taken. It was just he was shot and then they left the scene.
What were the circumstances that would have caused the hitman to take his life?
There are many allegations and theories going around. One of them is that that he was involved with labor issues. We don't know. But certainly what Mr. Sempe and I we had known each other a long time, and he had reported that his life is being threatened, and he did go to the police about a month before that and got a protection order.
At the heart of all of this is the Blaefor Workers Union, which the NUM accuses the company, your management, of starting and then entering into a closed shop agreement and forcing all of the workers at this mine to join that union. What is the Blaefor Workers Union? Did you start it as the management, and have you been forcing workers to join it?
This must be seen in the correct context. This mine went into liquidation some 7 years ago as the result of a wildcat strike that took place. At the time, the union that was recognized was the NUM, okay? Leadership then belonging to the Liquidated Employees Committee motivated with Mr. Sempe to form their own union so that they could have their own union and control the mine in that manner through their union. Mr. Sempe was a big community leader, and he assisted them to register the union. The union is legally registered with the Department of Labor, and the recruitment then that took place for membership very quickly rose to about 80% of the employees belonging to the Blaefor Workers Union. And that, of course, allowed us to into a close shop agreement with that union, because it is the recognized union by Blaefor Gold.
Okay, I'm hearing you saying that Mr. Sempe didn't indeed form the union, but yeah, you're saying it's with the workers, and he assisted
them. The leadership formed the union. He assisted as a community leader to give them direction on how to register it and how to do it, but he was not involved with the union.
Is there any truth then that Mr. Sempe's death was related to the tension between the NUM and the Blaefor Workers Union currently? And NUM claims that they were dismissed for refusing to join Blaefor Workers Union, and that they in fact have 50% membership here at your mine.
First of all, I cannot speculate on the tensions between Mr. Sempe that might have existed with other people. It is sub judice, it's being investigated by the police. So that is an ongoing investigation, and we're not aware of any findings yet. People were not dismissed for not belonging to the Blyfor Workers Union, and it certainly, NUM's claim that they've got a 50% membership is impossible, because at one stage, before the dismissals took place, they had a membership of about 130 people out of total labour force of 650 odd, so it was about a 20% membership. And as we stand at the moment, subsequent to the dismissals, the Blyfor Workers Union membership stands at 80%.
All right, thank you so much.
80% is not...
All right, that's the general manager. I'll have to leave it there, Mr. Lamsley. We're out of time for the moment. But giving some direct responses to the claims that were made by the union, and putting forward his own assertions that the NUM isn't the majority union here, that the union, Blyfor, wasn't started by the company. And this is, of course, happening while the NUM attempts negotiations to return to this mine as a representative body. Tulisizwe.
All right, Govan, thank you for that. Getting some clarity there about the role played by the mine itself in the establishment of this particular union. And one wonders what processes were being followed there. The word there from the union is that Mr. Sempe, the man who was killed, we are told, I don't know when exactly, but the union saying that he assisted in getting the union registered. He was, of course, an official of the mine, and the National Union of Mine Workers alleging that basically the mine is trying to get workers there at Blyfor to actually join this union that the NUM says has been started by the mine itself, which is a most unusual arrangement to have.